Welcome to another weird edition of Two Trek Tombstone with me, Jay Tombstone. I'm a little stuck on this topic, so we're going forward with it some more weird duets. I started a few days ago with, of course, the duet between Culture Club and Dolly Parton. I went on to the duet between Al Green and Annie Lennox, and I went on to the duet between Fred Schneider and Patti LaBelle, and I just keep going. I think this is the last one for now. There might come some later, but I just had to get this one out too, because these are some pretty weird duets as well. And let's start off with the mix-up between the KLF and Tammy Wynette. The KLF was like house music. They played kind of techno dance music in the late 80s and early 90s. And I think they were from England. I think they were like a British kind of DJ. They played house kind of trance dance music. And somehow, they ended up doing a song with Tammy Wynette. Which, unlike those other ones where I was like, how in the world did that happen? This song, it flat out tells you. Tammy Wynette says, they called me up in Tennessee and said, Tammy, stand by the jam. And if you don't like what they're going to do, you better not stop them because they're coming through. Here you go with Justified and Ancient, the KLF, featuring Tammy Wynette.
Started screaming, turn up the stroke.
The KLF featuring Tammy Wynette. Of course, Tammy Wynette's like the country queen, the queen of country, Stand By Your Man, all that. And the KLF was a flash in the pan of a British house music kind of band. And yet, they put out that song, and I really do love that song. Who doesn't love that song? I do have to say a note on that song, especially if there's any drag queens listed. I would just like to make a note. I don't know what that song's about. I have no idea what that song's about, and I've seen it done as many drag numbers. I've seen it done with drag queens dressed as a cow, Moo Moo Land, and more often, I've seen done as a drag queen doing it wearing a muumuu, you know, just a big old shapeless, you know what a muumuu is, a big old shapeless dress that's kind of flowered or something, brightly colored, and just a drag queen. You're a drag queen, people. If you're a drag queen doing drag shows, nobody wants to see you wearing a muumuu, okay? You're supposed to be a drag queen. Impress us. We are not impressed with a muumuu, really. Even if it, I mean, you doing a whole number based on a cute little pun, it's not original anymore. It's been done for decades. No more muumuus to justify an ancient. Please. Please, I'm begging you, drag queens. Please. No more muumuus to justify an ancient. Please. I can accept the cow outfit. It's a little bit cuter. But even that's not original. Just either do it. Look like, try to do like Tammy Wynette in character, or just don't do it. How's that? The next weird one, weird mix up, is really a great song, and they're both amazing artists. It's just kind of odd, because we all know, don't you know, I don't know if you know, but I feel like everybody in the world knows that Aretha Franklin don't fly. Y'all know that? Did you know that? I feel like it's common knowledge, but maybe it's not common knowledge, maybe it's just common knowledge in my world. But we all know Aretha Franklin don't fly, and George Michael lives in London. So how those two ended up doing this wonderful song together, I'll never know. And I just can't visualize the two of them hanging out. But like I said previously, a lot of these people do these duets and never even meet. They never even meet. They just do it. One of them does it in their studio, and somebody else does another studio, and then some engineers mix it together. And they never even meet, and they have a hit song together. With that said, this is the Queen of Soul, Aretha Franklin, and George Michael with I Knew You Were Waiting.
Endless delight.
Aretha Franklin and George Michael with I Knew You Were Waiting. There you go. And of course, I could keep going because I'm playing that and it makes me think his sisters are doing it for themselves and with Aretha Franklin and Annie Lennox doing a duet together. But I'll save that song for like some girl power show or something. So that's my little show. Weird mix-ups. And I think I'm done with that for now, that little topic. I'll try to come up with something different for the next one. I just want to say, you know, on Spreaker, if you have a Spreaker account and you're listening to this, you know that you have all these little statistics you can look at, and you can see who's been listening and how many people are listening every day. And I'm a little addicted to my statistics. I've said that before. And I just have to say, right now, my numbers are doing well. I have about 30 to 50 people that listen pretty much every day. And I really, really appreciate you. I don't know who most of you are, but I appreciate you listening to my little podcast. It brings me such joy to just share my stupid little music. I've always had such a quirky little taste in music, and I enjoy the bad music as much as I enjoy really good music sometimes, you know, and I have, like, all these weird old CDs that I just love to share music with. I was always a kid, like, I was like, here, let me play this song, you know, and I think it's a human nature thing, really, to kind of, like, when you hear something, you want to share it with other people, and some of these songs are, you know, like, some of my favorites. Those two are just kind of weird little things in my music collection. They just happen to be somewhere in there, you know, and I just, like, shared them. So, anyway, I'm just rambling on now because I've got plenty of time. Oh, no, it's like 14 minutes now, so I need to wrap it up. I need to wrap it up by telling you that I love you, and if you'll hit that little heart button around there or the like thing and say that you like this, I appreciate that. I haven't had a request in a while. Is there some song that you think I've never heard? Or is there some song you would just like me to play? Or is there a memory that you have of me? Or is there a question? For those people who don't know me personally, what would you like to ask Jay Tombstone? I'll answer anything. I'm gay, my mother's gay, my father's gay, my older sister's gay, and I have one straight sister who only dates Asian men. Thank you for listening, and I'll see you on the next edition of Two Track Tombstone with me, Jay Tombstone!